Dr. Deepa Dake is NEET Biology, and in today's session we are discuss about the water absorption as well as two most important part, apoplast and symplast. Secondly, we also study how do the apoplast and symplast helpful for the movement of water in plant. So let's begin with the topic water absorption. When we study, so here you remember water absorption is mainly take place by clear. So here you remember water absorptions when we study, root hairs are mainly responsible for the process of water absorption. Root hair, you remember, they are unicellular structures, and secondly root hairs develop from the epiblema of the or epidermis of root. So they are developed from the epiblema and they are unicellular structure. When we study about the water absorption, so here you remember we mainly discuss about the two path of water absorption. These two path of water absorptions are, first path is apoplast and the second path is called as symplast. So now we first study what is apoplast and symplast. So apoplast, you remember, if you study or you have a knowledge about the cell structure in plant, so cell wall is present in plant, first structure. Secondly, cell to cell communications are present in plant. Cell to cell communication in plant cell is commonly called as plasmodesmata. So these two structures you clear in mind when you study about the apoplast and symplast. One is cell wall and second is cell to cell connection or plasmodesmata. Now what is apoplast? Apoplast, you remember, apoplast means when water transport take place by cell wall to cell wall, then this path is called as apoplast. In simple terms, you remember. When we come towards the symplast, so symplast, you remember, the transport of water through cytoplasm, commonly we say transport of water via cytoplasm. Now the cytoplasm of the adjacent cell is interconnected with plasmodesmata. So generally symplast, you remember, though it take place through the cytoplasm of one cell to another cell, but here you remember originally it take place through plasmodesmata of the cell. So plasmodesmata you mainly remember for the symplast. Now we study, though these pathway apoplast and symplast are continuously present from epidermis towards the xylem, because when we study about the water absorption, so you all are knowing water is mainly conducted with the help of xylem tissue. Vessels and tracheids are the two conducting element of the xylem and responsible for the upward movement of xylem. Xylem always show the unidirectional flow of water. So that part you remember. So whether this transport via apoplast and symplast is continuously take place or at the particular layer or at the particular level apoplast gets stopped or broken down, that we study here. This part we study with the help of simple diagram. So here we study the arrangement of cell also. The simplest arrangement we study along with the diagram. Here you remember epidermis, epidermis followed by cortex, cortex is followed by endodermis, and then The endodermis is followed by pericycle, and after pericycle, you remember the water transport is take place through the xylem, and this xylem is mainly responsible for upward movement. Now when we draw the cell wall here, so you remember the cell wall of the plant cells are adjacent with each other, or adjacent to each other, and here they are interconnected with the help of plasmodesmata. So this part you remember here, the red color I use to show the cell walls. This part you remember. In this way cell wall is continue. Now the cell to cell connections are present. These cell to cell connections are called as plasmodesmata, and through the plasmodesmata cytoplasm of the one cell is in continuation with the cytoplasm of the another cell. Now this cell is the cell of epidermis or epiblema. After epidermis, the cortex, these layers you already studied in class 11. So cortex followed by, aap yahan pe study kar rahe hain, cortex is followed by endodermis. Now what is the important feature of endodermis? The endodermis show the presence of suberized bands. These suberized bands of the endodermis is called as Casparian strips. So these Casparian strips you remember. So these are the Casparian strips, and these Casparian strips students aap study karte hain when we study about the monocot and dicot root. So in that move aap study karte hain, the endodermis of the root, predominantly dicot root, show the bands of suberin. These bands of suberins are called as Casparian strips. Casparian strips you remember, Casparian strips are impermeable for water because they are deposited by the water impermeable substance suberin. So this part you remember, this layer is of endodermis. Then here it is pericycle, and here we come towards the xylem. Now when water is start to move, so cell wall to cell wall, when the water is moved from the cell wall to cell wall, so here you remember, suppose A we show here. So A, you remember A show the apoplast path, that is cell wall to cell wall movement is take place. Apoplast, you remember apoplast is only present from epidermis to endodermis. After that the apoplast path again kya hoga aapka block or completely closed, because the tangential wall of the endodermis show the presence of suberized strips or Casparian strips. So from endodermis the water is enter inside the cytoplasm, and after endodermis only one universal path up to xylem, one universal path is there, that was the symplast. When we study about the symplast, so plant cell show the single large vacuole, and the cytoplasm to cytoplasm water is transported. So B, you remember the B arrow are showing the symplast, and with the help of symplast, you remember with the help of symplast, once the water start to transport from epidermis, it continuously transported along with the xylem or up to the xylem. So this part you remember. So symplast, you remember symplast means it continue from epidermis to xylem. After that, once the water is enter in xylem, the water start to move towards the upward direction in xylem, and again when the water enters in xylem, so in root you remember, sorry, in xylem you remember, In xylem, the vessels and tracheids are the non-living components, and whenever the water transport is take place across a non-living component, then again it is take place by the apoplast. So again in xylem, when the upward movement of water is begins, so again both the elements predominantly in xylem, you remember, apoplast is again activate because the vessels and tracheids are mainly responsible for the water uptake, and vessels and tracheids are the non-living element of the xylem. So this part you remember. Now along with the diagram, we study what are the pathway or how the water transported through the different layers of the root. So now come towards the next, that is the transport of the water across the root. So student, this is the path of water inside the different tissues of the root. This is the transverse section of root we draw, that we already study in anatomy sections, where we study about the comparative analysis of the dicot and monocot root. Dicot root you already know, diarch to tetrarch condition is there. Now the first layer is epidermis, then multilayer cortex. Cortex is followed by a single layer endodermis, where the Casparian strips are present, and then the endodermis is followed by pericycle. Inside the pericycle, vascular tissues are present, xylem and phloem, four bundles of xylem, and besides that phloem is present. In roots, radial vascular bundles are present, and secondly cambium is always absent in the primary structure of the root. So this part you remember. Now mainly we study, discuss about the apoplast and symplast. When we study about apoplast, so you remember, root hair is responsible for absorption of water. Now what kind of water is absorbed by the root? Here you remember, when we study about the water absorption, so different types of water, chemically bound water, hygroscopic water, gravitational water, and capillary water. So here you remember, the capillary water is the only water which is available for the plant, and root hair always absorb this capillary water. This capillary water enter inside the epidermis and then follow the two pathway. The black one lining arrows are showing the pathway B. B pathway we study for symplast. So symplast, you remember, symplast is represented here, where the symplast is continue from epidermis till the xylem, because symplast means, sabhi clear hai, symplast ka meaning hai, the water transport is take place through cytoplasm to cytoplasm with the help of cytoplasmic connections or plasmodesmata. When we discuss about the apoplast, so apoplast you remember, cell wall to cell wall means the small amount of water is stored in intercellular spaces, and then again with the cell wall it transported to the next. So in this way, from the cell wall of one cell to another cell, water transport is take place, but this transport is present from epidermis to cortex, because in endodermis aap appear kar rahe hain. This is one Casparian strip is shown, simply for explanation is shown this way. Otherwise Casparian strips, you remember, arranged radially and tangential walls of the endodermal cell. Some special passage cells are present for the transport of water in endodermis cell. Through that passage cell, water transport is take place. So here one most important thing you remember for this diagram, due to presence of Casparian strip, the apoplast never be appear in endodermis, only the symplast pathway is present. So the symplast you as appear in diagram, clearly it is present across the endodermis, and through pericycle via symplast water is enter into the xylem. So this part you diagram you very well prepare for the path of water, and most important thing from the diagram you remember, Casparian strips. Secondly, apoplast and symplast, which one is apoplast and which one is symplast. So here you remember the diagram A and B, you remember, otherwise for easy, because in exams the black and white diagrams are generally comes. So in black and white diagram, it is quite difficult to remember. So simply you remember the path which is present only up to the endodermis, that is the apoplast, and across from epidermis towards the xylem. The path that is show the सिम्प्लास्ट और साइटोप्लाज्मिक कनेक्शंस के थ्रू पाथ हो रहा है. सो दिस मच यू रिमेम्बर फॉर द पाथ ऑफ वॉटर. सो अगेन व्हेन यू स्टडी अबाउट द पाथ ऑफ वॉटर, डोंट फॉरगेट अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग्स फॉर रूट हेयर. रूट हेयर्स आर यूनिसेल्यूलर, दे आर द आउटग्रोथ ऑफ द एपिडर्मल सेल्स और एपिब्लेमा सेल्स. सेकेंडली दे ओनली इंक्रीजेस द सर्फेस एरिया फॉर वॉटर एब्जॉर्प्शन एंड दे ओनली एब्जॉर्ब द कैपिलरी वॉटर. Apoplast means cell wall to cell wall, symplast means cytoplasm to cytoplasm or through plasmodesmata. Apoplast आपका कहां तक present है? It is only present up to the endodermis due to the presence of Casparian strips. In Casparian strips, suberin bands are present or suberin is deposited. So this part you remember, okay? Now in some additional structures आप study करते हैं. When we study about the path of water or water absorption, so we study about some symbiotic association, mycorrhiza. You remember mycorrhiza is mainly responsible to increase the water absorption in plant. Now mycorrhiza, you remember mycorrhiza, it is a symbiotic association where fungal hypha is grow along with roots of higher plant. This we already discussed. So roots of higher plant में आपके grow करते हैं. This you remember predominantly if you go through this section. So here you remember mycorrhiza are present in pinus roots. Pinus is a gymnosperm and the seeds of gymnosperm can't be germinate if the mycorrhiza is not available. Genus for the fungi you remember mostly the glomus. Genus of fungi participate in mycorrhizal association. Mycorrhiza is a mutual or symbiotic association in which fungi provide mineral and water to the roots of higher plant and root provide shelter and food to the mycorrhiza. Predominantly mycorrhiza when develop, so they are responsible to increase the phosphate ion uptake from the soil. So this much part you remember. I am not going in detail because mycorrhiza we already discuss in the fungi sections when we study about the fungi. So the students who are new, they can go through the above link which is mentioned here and study about the mycorrhiza or symbiotic association in fungi. So this is all for the water absorption in plant which we study under the transport of plant. Again, the students who are new, they kindly subscribe my channel, like my videos, and if you feel any doubt and difficulty in any topic, so please ask freely because examinations is yours and you have to clear this examination with very good marks and with good scores. So for that, best wishes from my side. Stay motivated and stay.